Some common experiences of our day-to-day life, like running, kicking a ball, opening a door, carrying things from one place to another, pressing the door, weightlifting, shaping the clay pot, tug of war or playing or any other action involves a push or a pull. How does this push or a pull affect a body on which it is applied? Welcome to the chapter Force and Pressure. In this video, let's understand the concept of force. In all the above activities mentioned, we either give a push or a pull. This push or a pull given to an object is called a force. When you kick a ball, you are pushing the ball. When you pull the drawer, you are actually giving a pulling force. Pushing the trolley, pressing the chapati dough, all involves either a push or a pull, and this push or pull given to an object is called as force. Forces occur only when objects interact with each other. Here you can see that the car and the man remains stationary. Since there was no interaction, the car does not move. But when the man starts pushing the car starts moving. So forces occur when at least two objects interact with each other. To see the effect of the force, interaction between the object and the source of force is necessary. When we are kicking the ball and the leg comes in interaction. Pulling the drawer, your hand and the knob of the drawer comes in an interaction. When you push the trolley, similarly your trolley and the hands are in interaction, similarly your feet and the ground, as well as when you press the dough, your hands and the rolling pin, similarly rolling pin and the dough are in interaction. There are many other examples to show that at least two objects must interact with each other. Have you ever seen a game of tug of war? In this game, two teams pull a rope in opposite direction. Each team tries to pull the rope in its direction. The team that pulls it with maximum force is the winner. Similarly, one cannot push a heavy box alone. But if another person helps to push the box in the same direction, then it moves quickly. This shows that when more than one force is applied in the same direction, the total force is the sum of both the forces. So let us see what will be the effective force in certain examples. If two forces act on a body in same direction, the net or the effective force on that body will be the sum of the two forces. For example, if F1 and F2 are two forces acting on the same body in the same direction, then the total force acting on that body will be F is equal to F1 plus F2. Here, the object will move in the direction of the effective force. When two forces are applied over an object from opposite direction, the total effective force is the difference between two forces. This can be explained mathematically as follows. On an object, F1 and F2 are two opposite forces acting on it, where F1 is greater than F2, then the net force is F is equal to F1 minus F2 and the object moves in the direction of the greater force. For example, here, if F1 is 400 units and F2 is the force which is applied on the body which is 100 units, then the magnitude of the total force or the effective force will be F1 minus F2 since the forces are acting in opposite direction. The answer here will be 300 units, but the object moved towards left as the greater force is F1. Here also, in this case, on the rope, the two teams are exerting opposite forces. Here, F2 is greater than F1. So, the net force will be F2 minus F1. And here also, the object moved towards left as F2 is the greater force. What will happen if equal and opposite forces act on an object? Here, both the teams are applying equal amount of force to pull the rope. That is, F1 and F2 are equal. How will you find the net force here? Remember, since the forces are opposite to each other, the net force will be obtained by subtracting or finding the difference of the individual forces. Since F1 and F2 both are equal here, the net force will be zero. Such forces which are equal and opposite to each other are known as balanced forces. Thus, A force can be larger or smaller than the other one. The strength of the force is usually expressed by its magnitude or value. The effect of force depends on the magnitude and the direction in which it acts. Force is measured in Newton. The SI unit of force is Newton. N is the letter used to represent the SI unit of force. Dear children, we have understood that force is a push or a pull or a both given to an object. Force cannot be seen. We can feel and observe the effects of force. So, what are the different effects of force? The various effects of force will be discussed in the next video. Thank you for watching the video. Like, share, and subscribe the channel for more videos of Class 8.